Ranos here, and welcome to the episode of Space Engineers. This episode taking a look at the composite thruster update, because I've added a new block, the noodle reinforced gyroscopes by Noodlemancer, as well as the steel catwalk with a small grid hole by Spaz86. Which the reinforced gyros and the catwalk was used in that little clip at the beginning. As you may notice with the part where the button came up. So anyway, how about we head on over here and take a look at them? First person. Now here is the gyroscopes. And you see, it's just basically a vanilla gyroscope with a bit of caging on it. That way it has, as you can see, mount points on all sides. Does make it a bit more useful in certain places, and less likely to break loose when a certain block is destroyed. That just makes things a bit more convenient. And it does have an increased build cost. Because the vanilla is 600 steel plates, 40 construction components, 4 large steel tubes, 15 metal grids, 4 motors, and 5 computers. As for this one, it's 75 steel plates, so 150 more. 50 construction components, so that's an extra 10. 10 large steel tubes, so that's twice as many. No, 6 more. 75 metal grids, that's 25 more of those. 20 girders, which is a new resource for it. As well as 5 motors, so it's got one additional motor for some reason. As well as 5 computers, which is the same as the vanilla. So yeah. Just a nice little cage around the gyro. And since the original base is used for this, you can easily stack them on, well, stack a vanilla on top of this one. And also, if you already have the vanilla gyro in your slot, oops, got to change the spec to that. Yeah. Anyway. You can see that with the vanilla item on your G menu, the reinforced one will also be there. Because they're part of the same group. You know, both gyroscopes. Yeah, punk. As you can see. Now, onto the catwalk with a small block hole. As you can see, this is the default vanilla catwalk with a hole in it. As you saw in the clip in the beginning, you can actually make a single rod of small blocks go through it. Thus, you can do some interesting things with it. Like have various things just extend out and whatnot. So you can do all sorts of crazy contraptions. For now, all I did was make a button go through it. That was a fun setup. And it was pretty good to get it working. As far as resource cost, it is 27 interior plates, 5 construction components, and 20 small steel tubes. Compared to the vanilla variant, but yeah, it's also in the same group, so it's easy to find. Huh, it uses more small steel tubes, as well as more interior plates, but less construction components. Huh. Interesting. So yeah, you can use this for all sorts of interesting things. What do you need to do with this? Okay, I'm looking at my hotbar. Yeah, you sure threw it. So you can also use it as a bit of extra defense. Which can be handy. No, the sun's going down. So anyway, the new addition to the composite thruster is this big thing. It's humongous. You can see, it is also hydrogen powered, being more efficient than the vanilla. As for its thrust force, which I need to put down vanilla as a comparison, well, the biggest vanilla one you can get. And heading over here. There we go. has a max thrust of 72 meganewtons, with a max usage of 64.27 kiloliters a second. You see, Vanilla only has 7.2 meganewtons, so it's 10 times as powerful and uses up a lot of fuel. It's not the most fuel efficient, but the amount of power it has means you don't need as many thrusters. Because having it as your main forward thruster is actually pretty useful. As for the flame, well, very bright. As you may have just seen there, each one of these things that goes around it is an individual thrust. Right, it has its own thruster flame. So it does look pretty cool. With being bigger than Vanilla, you have to plan for it better. Or plan for the size difference. But with it putting out 10 times as much power, I don't think it's going to be that much of a problem. I think some people would be really happy to have such a strong thruster. And a bunk. And that's really all there is about the thruster, apart from its build cost. Which is an expensive one. By the looks of it, its collision mesh is the which is a whole cube. Now, well, so anyway, it needs 400 steel plates, 310 construction components, 40 metal grids, 80 large steel tubes, as well as 280 thruster components. So it's not really cheap. Expensive, but worth it. Considering how much force you get out of the bugger. So anyway, I will have all three mods linked in the description below. You may download them and make your own contraptions with them. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.